Now this is a video that's been a long time coming. Been wanting to get this together for ages. What we're looking at is what I always maintain is the best rally I've ever owned, and it's a 1951 Superbe Sports Tourist. That's a Model 24 it was listed as. You can tell it's a sports, not only by the fact it says sports, but it has cable brakes and the slightly lighter weight frame. It's a Superbe because it's green and it's got the fork lock and it's got the lights. However, you'll notice if you're a student of these bikes that it has alloy rims and alloy mudguards. So that's really where the story of the bike begins. I'm going to tell you the story of this Raleigh Superbe. Right, take three. There's a small child that cries every time I hit record. So, let's go back to 1951. A Mr. Horn, who lived in a village just outside York and commuted into York every day, decided he was going to treat himself to his dream bike, his ultimate bike. So he went down to Russell's, a big old bike shop in the centre of York, which was a rally dealer, and ordered the top of the range, which was the Superbe Sports Tourist Model 24 in his size, which is the most popular size. And between 1950 and 1952 you could also get these bikes with Dunlop alloy rims. I'm trying to find where it says Dunlop on there, I'll show you later. So he made sure it had the alloy rims, and he also ordered a pair of Blue Mills Featherlight mudguards. You can see these have been broken and repaired over time. And the other optional extra was the dealer fitted green carrier. Now a lot of these bikes come with a carrier made by Prestube, which is a pressed steel sheet manufactured one, but back then this is what you got, a rather robust painted to match carrier. So he really bought the best that Raleigh could offer, and he was delighted with it, and he set about keeping a logbook of every trip, every day, every mile that he did, destinations, tea stops on the weekend, repairs, maintenance, all in a logbook. And he did that for almost exactly 50 years, until in 2001 he was just too old to ride anymore, and so he reluctantly sold it to a young enthusiast that he knew called Tom, who loved the bike, so Mr. Horn donated it to him. And that's where I come in. Now I had another Superbe similar to this at the time, and I'd not long moved to York, and I was working as part of a cooperative in bicycle transport, parcel deliveries, etc. And one of the founder members of the cooperative, this American chap called Chris, he really liked my Superbe, and he'd done me a big favour. So when I was in Cycle Heaven, the bike shop, one day, and I noticed on the notice board a card with Raleigh Superbe for sale, £20, I thought, I'll get that for Chris, I'll give it to him, a little project for him. So I rang the chap up, went round to his house, and that's when I met my long-standing friend Tom Riley. He was the vendor, and he also had a 1963 Moulton leaning on the fence, and I bought that as well, and that was my first Moulton. My other pal Josh, who had a Superbe and I used to ride with, he was into Moultons, so he encouraged me to buy one. But the Moultons are another side alley we're not going to go down. I've still got that 63, and there is a video about it not far down my channel. So I bought this Superbe and I gave it to Chris. Sometime later I was realizing that I hadn't seen Chris riding it, and then Josh, this other chap, rang me up in a bit of a fluster and said, I've just seen a chap riding to the tip with a Raleigh Superbe on a bike trailer. Well, my workplace was almost next door to the tip, and I'd moved workplaces by then. So I jumped on the bike and whizzed around there, and I intercepted the cyclist, and it was Chris taking this bike to the tip. So to say I was disgruntled is an understatement. So I took it off him, didn't give him much choice in the matter, and repatriated it and brought it home. I noticed that the forks were bent, so I took the forks out of my Superbe, which of course matched perfectly. Here's a little opportunity for you to see the difference between a black and a green Raleigh. So they all start off as black. They were dipped, bonderizing it was called, the process. They gave it the name bonderizing. And it was a hot dip black paint. So they were all painted black first, and then the green ones were sprayed green over the top. And you can see on this quite clearly how the green has come off, leaving the black underneath. Of course, the quality of the bonderizing and the quality of the steel means that the bike was covered in paint chips and scratches like this one. So I put the fork in out of my Superbe, put just another Raleigh fork in my Superbe and sold it on, and this became my main Raleigh. And I had many an adventure on it. But you can't keep them all. And in a moment of weakness, a few years ago, I needed the cash and I had too many bikes. A pal of mine had borrowed the bike at a vintage event that we're at, the Lavender Farm event, and he was really enamoured with the handling and the ride of the bike. And I had a little stall selling some bikes at that event, and ended up approaching Jeff, who runs the Liverpoolitan Tweed Ride, a few months later, said, are you actually interested in the bike? And he said, yes, I'd like it. And so it went to him, and it's been his since. He's replaced the saddle, the original one was absolutely falling to bits, and he still enjoys the bike to this day. So it's quite a story, quite a history. And what I really like about this bike is that, unlike a lot of old bikes, this one's never really been out of use. It's a bike that was ridden every day, looked after, maintained meticulously, records kept, and it was in continuous use for all its life. Plenty of things have been changed, but they've all been changed at different times in its life. You notice alloy brakes, front and rear, which are both slightly different from each other, so they've probably been replaced at different times. And the brake blocks are more modern. I think I fitted those. The brakes are worthy of mention on this bike as well. They are fantastic. The alloy rims have worn to such a smooth surface over the years that the brakes are absolutely tip-top. I wonder if maybe Mr. Horn or Tom or somebody has not been able to get those peculiar double-ended one-piece cables that the Raleighs came with and have replaced them. And this has now got Jeff's trademark on it, the Veuve Clicquot. Jeff has another Raleigh, a black one, and it's called the Black Widow. And this is something that Mr. Horn had on the bike, a St. Christopher. So, despite not being remotely religious or superstitious, couldn't really take that off because it's part of the bike's history. So, let's go for a little ride.